Example 5, use the given graph of f to graph p of x, which would be negative f of x plus 3. So the graph on the left is just a piecewise function. We haven't written a formal equation for it, but we have given you points that show how the graph changes on different pieces. So let's list the transformations. Well, first, negative f of x means that we're going to reflect over the x-axis. That's a vertical reflection. And then the plus 3, which is on the outside of the grouping symbol of the function notation, means we're going to shift up 3 units. So we have 2 transformations. So let me jot those down first, just under the graphs here. Show a little bit like that. So we have two transformations. We're going to take this parent graph f of x and we're going to do a vertical reflection over the x-axis, or about the x-axis, and then we're going to vertically shift up 3 units. So remember, what is the action that we take? Well, here, remember, we're going to multiply by negative 1, and then we're going to add 3 to the y values. Okay, so let's do that. The x values aren't changing at all. So the first point that we have, let's go ahead and jot down, I guess I'll do it here in the middle, f of x has these points, negative 4, negative 2, negative 2, negative 2, 2, 2, and 4, negative 2. We could probably give more, but let's just do those that are labeled. And then p of x, which is negative f of x plus 3, I'll just draw an arrow up there. We're just going to look at all the y values, multiply them by negative 1, then add 3. So I'm not going to change any of the x values. So I'm just going to jot those down first, because we didn't have any horizontal transformations. So negative 2 times negative 1 is positive 2, plus 3 is 5. And then negative 2 times negative 1 plus 3 again is another 5. And then positive 2 times negative 1 is negative 2 plus 3 is positive 1. And then we have another negative 2, which times negative 1 is positive 2, plus 3 is 5 again. So p of x will be over here, which is the opposite of f of x, plus 3. So negative 4, positive 5, which is off the page a little bit. So I'll just put it up here. Negative 4, positive 5. Negative 2, positive 5, 2, 1, and then 4, 5. So what we can see here is we stayed constant, then we decreased, and then we increased. So I'm just going to label these points here to make sure we have everything documented. So we can see that we've flipped over in the y direction, and we've also shifted up, and we preserved pretty much the shape of the graph because we didn't have any compression or stretch in either direction.